Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. If you want to learn how to build this custom steering box for your kayak, stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. Guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation, and I have configured a custom steering box made from simple pieces and parts that you can buy at any local hardware store. I'll start out by showing you what I've got here, and then we'll get into the working parts, guys. Right here I have my steering box. I made a custom pulley out of some plumbing parts inside. Also some plumbing parts, I made my steering handle. As you can see, it will allow you to rotate that motor 90 degrees left and right. So you can spin that kayak around on a dime and give them 9 cents change. So what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna take out the old cordless drill. We're gonna break into this box. I'm gonna show you exactly how I built this thing. All right guys, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my cordless drill. I'm gonna pull these four screws out right here so you guys can see the guts of this thing. This thing is so simple, you won't believe it, okay? So literally what I've done is I've taken a electrical conduit box here, and I've drilled a couple of quarter inch holes here in the back. This is some parachute cord. And right here inside, this is a piece of half inch PVC pipe, PVC elbow, PVC cap, some stainless steel screws. I went in here and took a half inch by inch and a half reducer, and I screwed that into a inch and a half by 2 inch reducer. And you can see inside there, I put a screw through all this to keep everything in line with my handle. Also, I screwed the inch and a half reducer into the 2 inch reducer. That's the simple inner workings of this box. Also come in here, right here, I just went inside and I tied a knot in my parachute cord, drilled a quarter inch hole, and came out of that, and I went both directions. That's the simplistic inner workings of my steering box. Like I said, this is just an electrical conduit box and some half inch PVC fittings and some a 1.5 to 1/2 inch. I think the actual term for it is called a bushing, and then 1.5 to 2 inch bushing. If you'll look right down here on the front, I've got a carabiner, and then I've got some more parachute cord that's tied to an anchor point here. And what this does is that keeps tension on my box from going backwards when I steer the steering, okay? This is a B-type ball right here, and I have a B-type ball underneath this box. Those are both mounted with stainless steel screws. The ones in the box are mounted with stainless steel bolts and stainless steel lock nuts underneath. Don't forget to put a little grease on those lock nuts underneath, because they'll seize up on you if you're not careful. That's a pro tip right there. So that is on about a 3 inch type B round mount arm. And moving back, I like to keep everything pretty detachable because I travel a lot sometimes, long distances. And I want to be able to strip my kayak down completely. So I try to make everything user-friendly, quick to assemble and disassemble. So what I've done here is I've added four carabiners. That way I can take these apart and this box comes off and I can put it up in my truck. I don't have any problems with it coming loose or anything. We'll move on back and I'll show you how I ran my lines. All right, guys, I ran my lines through these little, they're called pad eyes. I've got my right and left lines. I've got them separated. Now I come back here and I've got two sailboat pulleys. They have bearings in them, so they're nice and smooth. And then on my motor, I've got my lines, I've got them crisscrossed here. I've got my line coming up to the opposite side of the motor. I ran across here, I crisscrossed them here. You can see I ran over to this pulley and then up to get the crisscross. This is a steering T for my trolling motor. This allows me to detach this very easily. Like I said, I like to try to keep everything as simple as possible. Right here on the back, Also ordered this off of Amazon. This is a twist lock stainless steel connector, and that locks in place and you can't take it out without doing the twist lock, okay? So another feature I have is this pulley right here. It will lock my trolling motor in place. That way I can reverse without my trolling motor popping up. I used a carabiner here. I used a little piece of bungee cord to pull it back. That works really well. You can see it pulls and it locks that motor in place. Or I can let it back and you can pick the motor up using this other cable that I've got. I've also got all this on sailboat pulleys. These locks here, you simply pull your rope through and let it off and they will lock in place. Pretty easy. I made my T-handles out of half-inch PVC pipe. Drilled a hole big enough for it to go through there. I tied a knot in the pipe. And there you have it. That's an in-depth look at how my motor works. I love it. I don't believe I would change anything about it for a hand steer. I've never had a foot steer. I've been contemplating changing from hand steer to foot steer just because it gives me more freedom when I'm fishing. But it takes literally a second to reach over there and adjust your kayak one way or the other. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I've got tons of kayak hacks. I have highly modified this 11.5 Outlaw, and most of it's been stuff I've made myself or come up with myself. So if you guys have any questions, give me a shout on here. Hey guys, if you like this, please click that subscribe button. It helps my algorithm, and it helps me feel good about what I'm doing. Give me a old thumbs up. Drop us a comment down there, and don't forget to turn on that little notifications bell so you'll know when we drop a new video. Got some exciting news of a new modification I'm just about to start, okay? I'm about to make my own dashboard, hook up my 9-inch graphs, got a custom-made battery box that I'm going to be running that off of, and I'm also going to customize my black pack to hold my 100 amp lithium battery for my trolling motor. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. I'm John, and I want to wish all you guys out there tight lines, guys.